Jersey.
Come on, kid. I said, who the fuck are you to be walking down that wing without any fucking boots or shoes on? Must be one bad motherfucker, dog.
Yeah.
You ain't gonna be doing that in the pen, man. Yeah, the motherfucking medium and shit. Hell yeah, go in your flip-flops. They don't give a fuck. Run down that bitch in your boxers.
Yeah, I done seen that too.
You want to get turned out or something? They might think you're trying to advertise, man. Shit. It's crazy, ain't it?
Yeah. So what you would say you're different between? Because you done spent like 20 years in prison. You done did like 10 in the state?
Yeah, I did 11 my last time.
In the state? Yep. And then the federal,
about
11 in the federal.
Yeah. It's a whole different ball game, man, the state and the federal. Especially when you're at the pen. Yeah.
Okay, would you say your state time is comparable to your time in Atlanta in the medium?
No, I'd rather be in Atlanta than to be in a state joint.
Why you say that?
Because it's more organized. What I mean is you don't hear cracker this, pussy ass cracker that all day long.
Mm-hmm.
When you go from the county to the state joint, that's all you hear all day long.
Mm-hmm.
And you might get jumped at any minute. They ain't allowed to do that in the pens. When something pops off, like he said, man, the whole posse's there. It's already been planned out. Mm-hmm. You already know what's going to happen. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. You know what's fixing to happen. You got to do your part, man. In the state, they might just come out from anywhere and beat the shit out of you, man.
Right, and then your homeboys ain't gonna help you.
They might stand there and watch. It ain't gonna be like that in the feds. Hell no. Motherfucker jump on you in the feds and your homies are around? Shit. Man, they getting right in there, man.
Yeah.
I don't care if it's one-on-one, man. A lot of them won't even go for that. The only way they do one-on-ones in the pen, if the shot callers say, all right, you two are going in the room and y'all are gonna knife each other. We're gonna have a couple dudes standing outside the door. When we come in and tell you to quit, y'all quit. That's the only way you're gonna go one-on-one. You see what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
For real. You ain't allowed to do shit on your own in the pen. Whoever the representative is over that, he's the one that's gotta get with the representative that you got problems with, and then they decide what's gonna happen. And if they can't come to an understanding, then it's on, man. Just meet on the rec field, or, you know, if you can, if you're not like somewhere like I was telling you about. In Atlanta, you can meet on the rec field.
Right.
You ain't gonna get along in the fight, because they're gonna be hanging the guns out the tower, shooting, and all, they're gonna come out of the woodwork.
So this last time you went back on a violation.
Yeah.
You went to Coleman one.
Right.
How long you were there?
I had a year. Well, I did about 4 months, 4 or 5 months
there. And what happened?
Then the independents got in with some other white dudes, and they locked us all up, and that's when they sent me to Polite.
Inside your cell on the rec yard?
Inside the pods.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
It ain't too much
white. It was whites on whites, man. But I was an independent pod. I was an independent people. These people were gang members we got into it with.
Right.
You know, so.
And it was inside the cell.
And it's right inside our pod, yeah.
Right.
It didn't last long, you know, a little bit of fighting and, you know, a little bit of stabbing, but they can get in there and bust that shit up a lot quicker. When they come in, they're coming in macing you and whatever, shooting you with the electric guns, with the
tasers.
Yeah, like the police has got, they got them.
Right.
And when they come in there, they got bulletproof vests on, so you can't really do nothing to them.
So when you left Coleman, you went out to Louisiana.
Yeah.
To Polop.
For my last couple of months.
So how was I there?
Man, I don't ever want to go back there, man.
Mm-hmm.
That motherfucker. Like he said, Coleman 1 is so laid back. Unless something pops off, but most of the time. But at Polock, it's always tension, man. Somebody's getting fucking jumped on every day, Kevin.
Mm-hmm.
Every day, man. For some dumb shit, man.
And like you were telling me once before, like once you get there, you check in, orientation.
You do your orientation, and when you go to the yard at Pollock, when you get ready to go to your dorm at Pollock, the dudes are standing out there to represent whoever you run with.
Mm-hmm.
Like me, I just go independent. Like you, you might run with your homies from Tampa or
down
Crips
south
or whatever. So they're going to tell you who to go see when you get to your dorm.
Mm-hmm.
Go see him. He's going to take care of you. You got 30 days to get your paperwork.
What do you mean when you say your paperwork?
You got to have your PSI sent in.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. You got to have that PSI. You don't really have to have your PSI anymore. You got to have your docket sheet.
Right.
And what the docket sheet shows is everything that went on with your case. Mm-hmm. And if you didn't have any kind of hearings, you know what I mean, special hearings, they can tell off the docket sheet.
Right.
If you've been, your PSI is going to have everything, as you know. All the way back when you was a kid, man.
Right.
Yeah.
So at Pollock, once they tell you what's going on, hey, you need to holler at him what the next phase is.
The next phase, they're going to tell you where who you're going to sell it with. And then
who tell you that? The officer or the...
The motherfucking convicts tell you that. The officer don't tell you shit when you go in the dorm.
Mm-hmm.
They keep rooms. There's certain rooms in the dorms that are... The white boys' rooms, the black dudes' rooms, the Spanish rooms. You'll never move in one of them rooms.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't matter. Them people could be leaving or go to the hole. The police ain't going to give them rooms to nobody else.
Right.
They're going to let one of their other homies move in there. You see what I mean? They're going to hold that room down. Because each person's going to have five or six rooms, you know, for each, you know, car.
Right.
And them
right.
rooms will always be them people's rooms. I'm talking about not the same person, but the gang members or whoever.
Right.
Sure, man.
What about you were saying while you were there at Pollock, somebody had stabbed somebody.
Oh, yeah, man. That D.C. boy, man.
Yeah.
He already had three lives, but he found out his roommate stole something. He fucking slaughtered him in the cell.
Stole something from who?
Stole something from him in the room. He said somebody, he stole something from him. That's what they say. I don't know for sure. Mm-hmm. But that's what the rumor was.
Right.
So he went in there and gutted him at count time.
Mm-hmm.
And then all they did to him was send him to the edX for 5 years. They didn't even give him a new charge. And killed the dude, man. Killed him dead.
Where's a roommate from?
He's from D.C. too.
Oh, here from D.C. too?
Yeah. But them D.C. boys, they do a lot of stealing and mess with faggots.
Yeah.
Yeah, they do.